direction in which Gabriel stood. "I can make you happy," said he to the back of her head, across the bush. "You shall have a piano in a year or two. Farmers' wives are getting to have pianos now. And I'll practice up the flute right well to play with you in the evenings." "Yes, I should like that. And have one of those little 10-pound gigs for market. And nice flowers, birds, cocks and hens, I mean, because they are useful," continued Gabriel, feeling balanced between poetry and practicality. Gentlemen and a lady. Yes. And when the wedding was over, we'd have it put in the newspaper list of marriages. Dearly, I should love that. And the babies and the births, every man jack of them. And at home by the fire, whenever you look up, there I shall be. And whenever I look up, there will be you. Shadow pools of devotion. We pant for revelation and dwell in prayers of confession. This is the point of lesser thought, staring into vacant water. Desire is not enough. Your desire and will not sway the space and speed of increased returns. Who can see the wind? The snarl of change. He really didn't know the phenomenon of propositions or the meandering of animals. Escalators of speech. The sacred object of language. Written tracts, a trail of words. Spoken to a friend who understood incompleteness of mathematics. And the handling of snakes. Arnold Bennett says that the horror of marriage lies in its dailiness. All acuteness of relationship is rubbed away by this. The truth is more like this. Life, say 4 days out of 7, becomes automatic. But on the 5th day, a bead of sensation between husband and wife forms, which is all the fuller and more sensitive because of the automatic, customary, unconscious days on either side. That is to say, the year is marked by moments of great different. This man and this